Hey, yo guys, Ruben here, long man. I'm upgrading my setup, so we're doing another unboxing video. Today, I've got a Samsung Odyssey G4 240Hz new gaming monitor. Let's unpack this bad boy. Big box. Open the plastic safely. Cables, HDMI cable and a power cable. This does not come with a DisplayPort cable for the 240Hz, but I already have one in my 144Hz monitor that I currently have there. So I'm gonna replace that one, use that one. I've got, let's see, looks like it's a ring to put on the mount at the back. I'll keep that in the styrofoam for now. We'll look at the instructions in a bit. We've got, take all this styrofoam stuff off. This is the seat, the foot. Seems sturdy, seems wide enough. Decent weight to it, but not too heavy. Put this down for now. What do we got here? I think the rest is all the actual monitor. Some styrofoam garbage. It has an E-energy label for those curious. Important with the current energy energy prices. We've got an installation guide here. This is, yeah, this is also part of the stand. Okay. So this part is gonna go into the foot, like this. Whoop. Let me screw that with a screw, I think, probably. Yeah, there's a screw here, so I can screw that in when we set it up. And then this ring is gonna, well, what's the ring doing? Oh, you can take the ring apart, you can like split it. Then we can put it back together over on top of it. I'll go get a screwdriver and then we'll set up the mount and then we can move on to the next step. Got myself a screwdriver. Now let's continue. According to the instruction guide, we need to hold this upside down. This down here, kinda. Can put this on here, and then we can screw. Okay, there we go. Next step, we need to remove the styrofoam in this, and we can put this on the back of the monitor and secure it in place. Let's see how that looks. Let me put this down. This camera so you can see how it looks in the box. Go, so we can just put the square off the holder on the back of this thing. Let's see if this works. Okay, there's some these points can go into the end here, I see. Slide it in. Okay, this box. It needs
needs to be secured at the bottom as well, so I need to lift this up a bit with the box. And now I think it's, it looks like it's secured there. I heard it click. And now I think we can put the ring over it.
The rings on the side here, and this one as well. Okay, think about it. This is no, it's not in there. Okay, I don't like the ring. This is too complicated. It's not working properly. Try the other side. This is all in there. Now this side needs to go here as well.
Okay, it's locked in now. That definitely took too much effort, but it's in. Before we put this bad boy in its place, I'll show you my current setup and tell you how we're changing it. Here is the current setup. Got the Titan XL, leaned back the HyperX Quadcast that we unboxed last time. Then my current dual monitor setup. We've got this one, a BenQ 144Hz monitor. And then we've got this really old square monitor. I don't even know what it's HP. But this one is breaking the buttons, and on the bottom here are messing up, and it's falling down. And this one is also a bit worn out. So what we're gonna do is, this one's gonna go, this one's just gonna go away. This one is going to move over, become my second monitor. And the new 240Hz monitor is going to be there as the primary screen. Okay, now it's time to move the monitor in its place. Clamps in the way. Smooth. Ah, there we go. Turn backwards. Here it is, our new, brand new monitor. Let me put it in the right place and I'll show the new and the old side by side. Here they are next to each other. As you can see, this one 27 inch, this one 24 inch. Quite a difference. You can also see this one needs a bit of a cleanup. But this one is really high right now. So, but I think we can lower it a bit on the stand and put them more in lines. So I'm gonna see how to do that and I'll be back. Adjusting it appears to be really easy. You have to take off this thing that's on the back of the stand, and now I can just easily move it up and down, tilt it back and forth. So now I can set it up just how I want to. Let's get this bad boy plugged in and then we'll see how it looks when it's on. And here we are, the BenQ on the right and the new Samsung G40 on the left. It looking very nice. I'll still have to figure out the settings and how I want to set everything up with the colors and stuff like that. There is one minor thing I forgot, something very important. I forgot to do this. Very satisfying. Second thing I forgot, I had a DVI cable, not a DisplayPort cable. So I will have to order one of those, because this one only came with an HDMI cable. But I'll swap that around and get that fixed so we can enjoy that 240Hz goodness, which I'm unfortunately gonna have to do without tonight. But I'll get that sorted out soon. And then after I've played with it in a little bit, I can maybe do a review video. So, hope you guys enjoyed another unboxing, and I'll see you soon with more vlogs, adventures, cosplay, and other content. Hit the subscribe button, and I'll see you later. Bye-bye.